What if you were trying to make your customers extra happy and there's all kind of information about them and you want to make it easier for your employees to understand how to use that info? Find out how on this next episode of the Cozy AI Kitchen. I am so happy to have Dr. Kim Morita, the best dentist in the Bellevue-Redmond area, on the Cozy AI Kitchen. Welcome, Dr. Kim.
Oh my goodness. Thank you so much for having me. What an honor.
So I know you're like fresh off of different things you're doing in the wellness space. Can you share with the audience your philosophy on oral health just briefly? Because I know you can go like for a TED Talk, but yeah.
So I'm a general dentist, and we're always trying to prevent oral disease. So that's cavities, it's gum disease. And so our practice is really focused on preventative care. And so my goal is to not only share what you need to do with your mouth, but have patients kind of understand that there is really an oral systemic link to everything, make it more meaningful for them.
I gotta say that when I came into your office, it was like a magical feeling. I felt like I was at like a Tesla dealership or something in terms of the use of technology, but also human care. So glad to be here. So we're gonna be cooking today a special AI recipe to address one of the problems you have. I understand your practice is getting bigger and you have some challenges.
Yeah. As we grow, as the practice grows and gets to scale, I mean, one of the things that we care about is keeping the patient experience really personalized. And I understand that dentistry, you know, a patient going to the dentist, it's not for everyone. Some people love it. You might love it, but some people don't. And so in an effort to make it more comfortable for them, we really try to do personalized care.
And personalized care is hard because of information that's unstructured often. So that's why we use things like words now. This is my jar of embeddings. So you don't mind like putting a few embeddings into the, go ahead, pour some in there. Yeah, there we go.
Oh.
Yeah, that's good. That's information that you have in there. Okay, good. And because everything in this world of new AI is probabilistic, it's like rolling the
dice.
Exactly. So could you put some dice in there for it? There we go. Yeah.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay. And you know how to do this.
You've been in the kitchen before.
You're like a leader. Exactly. Totally. Excellent. Scientist leader. Okay. Now, I want to note that we're going to use this basic technology with the power of the new microwave oven we have in the kitchen. We're going to use what's called personas to create an AI agent just for you. Would you mind giving me one agent you like in there?
Okay. Yeah. All right. Yeah. But this one.
That's a good. Oh, very good. That's a good one.
Is that a good one?
Okay. We're going to get that ready here in the oven. Okay. Good. Good. Oh, good. All right. Let's start cooking that on the
car. Okay. I'm excited.
Okay. Here we go. Okay. Can't wait to get started with this one. Okay. All right. So, here we go. I know the personas are heavy.
Oh.
Okay. All right. Code is up. Okay, so first off, what we do is, just want to note that Dr. Morita gave a presentation for Stanford Be Well. I just want to say that I've never thought about the mouth as a place of health, but thank you for doing that for all of us.
I love it.
I appreciate it. Okay, so, and this is the problem that Dr. Morita's practice is facing, and as a leader, the CEO has to figure out how to make it better for your people, right? Mm-hmm. So we've made a special agent just for you, and the agent is called the Morita Huddle Manager.
Okay. I love it.
All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring over some packages, and we're now going to fire up a semantic kernel, and then what we're gonna do is get the right model. I want to note that we're using GPT-4. You know, in the kitchen, we use 3.1, it's kind of a little heavy here. 3.5, I figure you're super strong. 3.5 turbo. But for you, we're going to use GPT-4.
Ugh, with eyes on it.
Thank you. Exactly. Eyes, vision. Exactly. So we're going to use 4. And in the 4, we're going to process this. And I'm pulling over some agent code I wrote with the Morita Huddle Manager in there. You see it's arrived, and you can see the job description. Your job is to deliver custom instructions to members of the team. The members, I've just put fictional members in there to sort of like anonymize it. Pam, Jim, Jan, and Steve. Now we're going to hatch the agents. And so this part, pause. You've heard of prompt engineering. And so prompt engineering for AI, but this is writing a job description. So it's a little different. You're not sort of telling the AI to do something. You're creating a job. So this job sounds like a job that is that job. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Great.
That job could work. And again, you can change the job as you like anytime you want. Then we're going to hatch the agents. I say hatch because I watch Aliens, the movie. It's all very friendly. And now we have created a semantic kernel experimental agent. And now let's assume the day starts.
Okay.
And you have special requirements for certain patients. So certain, they are Jim at 9 a.m. has a back problem, needs pillows and a blanket. Jan's patient. Imagine this to be a really long list. Sometimes it's Jim. Sometimes it's Jan. It's like, oh, but it's everything you know about what has to get done for your patients. And so we're going to add that into the brain.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Then we're going to need a thread. A thread is an aspect of these AI agents. And now we'll let the agent do its thing. So it's going to basically take those notes for today, and it's going to lay out a suggestion for what to tell the different people in the Morita Dentistry office so that you'll be able to give the instructions. Here it goes. So for Jim, your 9 a.m. patient has a back problem. For Jen, your 10 a.m. patient has teeth sensitivity issues.
Yep.
Giving suggestions. It's almost as if it's signed by you almost.
I the writing.
Okay, so now let's assume, now let's say you want to be able to talk to instead. So let's say someone's checking in and saying, I'm Jim, what should I do today? Maybe they couldn't make it to your huddle.
Okay.
I know everyone shows up on time.
Right.
So maybe like a half a second late or something.
Right.
And so the huddle manager is saying, hey, Jim, prep some extra pillows. But instead, the huddle manager could just basically talk to them.
Hey, Jim, prep some extra pillows and a blanket for your 9 a.m. patient with a back issue. Oh, make sure they're comfy. Thanks. Amazing.
And then they could also send an email to Jim and Jan, et cetera, as well. So can I give you a sense of like what this kind of technology could do?
I mean, there's a lot of these touch points that we can communicate with our team to make it, you know, a streamlined experience for our patients and still keep it personalized to the best that we can do. Super cool.
Yeah, I was surprised too. Again, this code I wrote basically in 1 hour, which was weird. I'm not good. This AI is amazing. So again, dentistry, difficult profession, high customer care. At the same time, though, if this can do the things that are less about the part that you have all this expertise, tell me what this can do in terms of your workload.
I mean, can really make it more efficient and then still keep it as personalized as possible. So, you know, in the world of dentistry, having AI seems to be a really helpful tool for us.
Could be, right?
Yeah.
So can you part with your thoughts on the mouth again? Because again, you've taught me about how this thing is very special.
It is.
Can you share with our kitchen audience? Because they're cooking and they have this thing called saliva. You talked a lot about that.
Yeah.
Let's go there.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, the mouth, the entrance to your body, it's the first place that, you know, you see before the body. And as we're cooking, it's important to have good nutrition. Saliva is a special liquid. It keeps the oral ecosystem balanced. And if it's tipped off, you can tip it towards disease. So you want to support good health that way. And floss every day. Keep your teeth clean and integrate AI into all of this to make it a streamlined experience.
Okay, you heard it there. Take care of your teeth, take care of your gums, and again, floss, you're saying?
Every day.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Morita.
Thank you so much for having me. It was an honor.
Well, and let's keep on going in the Cozy Eye Kitchens. Let's see what's next. And again, Valby Redmond, the dentist. Thanks again.
Thank you. Bye-bye.